I think it's both. Myself, I haven't been around during recruiting season yet, but from what I understand, the Fort Scott coaches have done some things that haven't exactly set well with our coaches and, for that matter, any other coaches in our conference. And that has done nothing but intensify the emotional feeling between the two staffs. And I think that when you're investing a lot of time and effort with your players, you kind of admit that to them and they pick up the same type of thing. They say they have kids and all their kids, and that's another way that the rivalry is a big thing. So no doubt about it, this is probably the biggest rivalry we have every year, maybe other than anything. Start out the game. We set a goal this week that we were going to come out to school right off the bat. Of course, I know everyone out there thinks that that's our goal every week, and it is, but there have been some times when we've played a little bit tentatively to start the game, trying to see exactly what they're going to do. This week we wanted to come out and shoot as fast and as quickly as we could and get some things on the board and start stepping ourselves right away. I think we began exactly the way we wanted to. We started out here with a couple first downs. Came back and ran a triple option play with Jayhawks. I believe in the last two or three weeks we've really developed a great leader for us. And it's really allowed the leadership qualities that he has to come through. Moving the ball now, we're going to have a sweet play with Abbott Williams, the sophomore, a redshirt freshman running back for us from St. Louis. Abbott has done a good job for us, and unfortunately there he got a little bit overextended and didn't have good ball leverage and lost the football. So our defense comes out. They're looking to make a big play right off the bat. We start off well. Big talk, and you can see a bunch of people around the football room. Just like we mentioned last week, that's a goal of ours. I think with the added incentive of the rivalry and the intensity and emotions involved here, they lived up to being a good defense.
Now, Coach, it's been said that Fort Scott can pitch about four, just about anywhere. What is it? What quality do they have in the game of the sport?
Well, I think they have some very good athletes, for one. The other thing is their attack is a passing-oriented attack, and when you throw the ball, you're going to throw the ball farther than you would expect to run the ball, and big things can happen. Someone misses a tackle or misses a cover. In a matter of the same amount of time it would take maybe five or six plays to get the ball the same distance, in one play, you've maybe scored or made a big gain with the pass. Here, Mickey Lynch, number 11, our hawk, what we call our hawk, a strong safety, does a tremendous job on reading the routes that they run and comes up with the interception. So we come back. Tracy Strong has played a much better game this week than he has perhaps all year, with the exception of the positive independence. We were expecting a lot out of him this week, and I think he delivered for us. Our offensive line did a fine job and graded overall close to the highest we've graded to this point. Here we run the fullback trap with Tracy, who seems really struggling and fighting for yardage. So the quality of good and great running backs
on the tackle for that on the night. We had a very physical ball game.
We really did. Here Brian McClure catches a dip and gets us a few more yards and now we're inside the 10.
Brian McClure on the
I think that we knew that up front.